Good morning. What a lot of rain we had yesterday. Everything's going to be growing like crazy. Everyone's going to be cutting their lawns and stuff. But apparently next week it's going sunny again. So that will be nice. We can meet each other for walks and garden coffees and stuff. So that's great. I'm looking forward to that. So I hope you enjoyed the beginning of yesterday's devotional. This might be an obvious statement, but it's very different to the last devotional we did. But we'll keep going with it, and maybe in a week's time or something, send me an email with some feedback. Let me know if you're enjoying it. Let me know if it's helpful, if it's encouraging you, if you're learning, or if you don't like it. And I'm also going to include in this email, I'm going to include a devotional for the children. I just thought this is such a long time now for them to be out of kids' church, and I know they do get a segment on a Sunday morning, but it's very different. So I thought I'd try doing a kids devotional as well. I'll do it for a little while. So if you have kids, or if you have grandkids, or know of any kids that would benefit, it's a kind of science-y-based devotional by a guy called Louis Giglio. And it's very fun. It's probably aimed for slightly older children, but I think the younger children would enjoy it too. So I will include that on this email. And just send me some feedback, whether you think it's a great idea, whether you think there's not enough kids or whatever. But even if it reaches five kids and encourages them, then that's great. So today we are reading Don't Be Robbed. And our reading is Colossians 2 verse 8. It reads, "Beware lest anyone cheat you through philosophy and empty deceit, according to the tradition of men, according to the basic principles of the world, and not according to Christ." In yesterday's reading, I hope you saw clearly that in 1 Corinthians 2, the Apostle Paul did not say that those who are unworthy cannot partake of the communion. Reread those verses closely. Paul was talking about the unworthy manner in which one partakes of the communion. He was writing to the Corinthian church, whose members were treating the Lord's Supper with irreverence, eating to satisfy their hunger, with no consideration for others, and even getting drunk. And that's in 1 Corinthians 11, 20-22 in the Amplified. It is clear Paul was correcting them for treating the Lord's Supper like any other meal, rather than partaking of it in a manner that was worthy of what our Lord Jesus had ordained it to be. They were treating the communion as something ordinary, instead of seeing it as holy and set apart. For us today, to partake of communion in an unworthy manner is to treat the elements of the communion as common, insignificant, and powerless. It is to treat the communion elements as natural and ordinary, as nothing more than a cracker and some juice, and to fail to recognize the potent, sacred force we get to hold in our hands. It is to disdain the elements and to be like the children of Israel, who got so familiar with the manna God in his grace provided that they saw the bread from heaven as worthless. And we see that in Numbers 21 verse 5. It is to simply go through the motions of eating the bread and taking the cup without valuing the significance and power they contain. Maybe you've never really understood why Christians partake of the communion. Maybe it's an empty ritual to you, something you do because your church conducts it occasionally. Maybe you are partaking of the communion because you heard healing testimonies from others and you are hoping it might work its magic for you. Or maybe you see it as a sentimental custom or a quaint tradition that simply reminds Christians about the roots of their faith. If any of those maybes describes you, may I tell you that you have been robbed. The good news is, God is reaching out to you through the pages of this book to bring you a clear understanding of what the Holy Communion is really about. I pray that as you keep on reading over the course of these 90 days, your eyes will be opened and your body will fully receive the healing power of the Holy Communion. It's so lovely. It's so lovely to know that communion isn't just bread and wine or bread and juice. It's not common. It's not the same bread you could just go and give to the pigeons or whatever. It's sacred and it's holy and it's powerful. And it's so lovely. In the rest of the book, we're going to discover about that and learn more about that. But isn't it reassuring that we're not just doing some empty ritual just because we're Christians and that's what we do, because Jesus said to do it. Actually, Jesus said for us to do it because it benefits us. It's there for our good. It's there for our protection, our healing, we're already forgiven, but to remind us that we're forgiven. It's there for our building up. It's there to proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. And it's a powerful thing. So it's so wonderful to know that we're not part of something that's empty and just ritualistic. It's actually something with huge significance that we're going to find out about. So our prayer today, Father God, thank you for showing me that the elements of the Holy Communion are not common, insignificant and powerless, but powerful to affect the healing you want me to experience. Thank you for your word that renews my mind to your eternal truths about the communion. I declare that I will not be robbed of its power. In Jesus' name, amen. And our thought today, the Bible says God's people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. That's in Hosea 4, verse 6. Your lack of knowledge about the Holy Communion is really about... your lack of knowledge about what the Holy Communion is really about has been destroying you, and you don't even know it. It's time to take back what the enemy has stolen. Sorry about my tongue tie there. But what he was just saying is, like, the enemy has stolen from us the truth of the communion, and now we're taking that back. We're taking back the knowledge of what communion is for us. Okay, so check out the kids' devotional. It's actually really fun. So if you want another devotional to listen to, they're quite interesting. So I'm going to read that one now. We'll attach it to the email, and I hope you have a great day. See you tomorrow. Bye.